So now the object is placed between the center of curvature and the focal point. Right? Between the center of curvature and the focal point. So complete that drawing the principal axis, selecting the midpoint on the principal axis, then drawing the symbol of the lens. After that, select equal distances points here, either sides. Then name them as F1 and F2 respectively. Next, selecting two more points equal distances from the pole. Then name them as C1 and C2. Don't forget the logical rules while drawing the ray diagrams. Okay, that's why I'm repeating every time. Next, position the object. Where?
Between F and C.
C2 and F2 here. That height of the object is equal to the width of the scale. So that upward arrow you have to draw. Then choosing the parallel light ray. Okay. From the object, top of that object, drawn parallel light ray. If you want to complete that behavior of light ray after refraction, you can complete it. Or next also you can complete, no problem. So first you have to complete that behavior. After that, choose the second ray. What is second ray here? Passing through the optic center of the lens. So select that ray. What is the behavior of this light ray after refraction? Remains?
Undeviate.
Now look at. Extend that where they are going to meet each other. So I got the converging point or not? I have the converging point or not? After refraction. Yes, I have converging point. So identify that point. From there you have to draw a perpendicular line onto the principal axis. Is it below the principal axis or above the principal axis? Is it below or above the principal axis? Image.
Below.
Below the principal axis. So what type of image is this? Type of image and facing direction.
Inverted.
Type of image is?
Real image.
What about the size?
Same magnified image.
What about the position?
Beyond C1.
Okay, beyond the center of curvature. Let me write the characteristic size. One is real image. Next one is inverted image. Next,
it is magnified.
Magnified. Next, beyond the center of curvature. Is it clear? So, draw the ray diagram properly using the scale.